I'm sitting on my $20 Facebook Marketplace couch in Vancouver to tell you the story about how I got here.
To the town of Arfield rode a stranger one fine day. Strangers there among them held a iron on his stick. Big iron on his stick. Big iron on his stick.
So we all know that the coronavirus has drastically impacted everybody's lives, and it has not impacted mine as badly as some other people, and my heart goes out to them. But I did have to drive back to Ontario in March because school shut down and I got kicked out of my residence. So cheers to that, UBC. Oh wait, I didn't even actually drive back to Ontario. I flew back and I shipped my car on a train. That's a whole other story, and I just hate moving. I'm never doing it again. My car was in Ontario, I was in Ontario, and I said I want to go back to Vancouver for the fall, even though classes are online. And so that meant that I had to drive through Canada. So if you're familiar with road trips and driving across Canada, you know that if you want to get from point A to point B, going through the US is much faster. Like, I'm talking days faster than driving through Canada, because driving through Ontario takes like 3 days by itself. Anyways, so I was gonna drive through Canada, and I was at brunch with one of my best friends, Allie, and I was telling her that I was so stressed about packing and I was doing this trip all by myself. And then she looked at me with that look that she always gives me when I tell her about an adventure. And I knew that I was gonna have a companion for the ride. And so this is a story of how my best friend Allie and I drove across Canada in 2 weeks during the coronavirus.
Less than a week after Allie had agreed to go on the trip with me, it was finally time to depart on our grand adventure. So at 4 a.m. on August 8th, we woke up, got in the car, and started our journey to the first destination, which was Pancake Bay Provincial Park.
Cheers!
How are you feeling?
Doesn't feel real, to be honest. I think I'm just cruising, we're just vibing with all the stuff in the back, and I feel like we're just going to get lunch.
Yeah, the
at
car,
5 in the morning.
The car is packed to the brim. Today, we have 9.5 hours of driving.
Plus pee stops, so.
And groceries.
Yeah.
And the large nickel. See you then.
Big kids looking here.
Allie and I have driven 5 hours just for this, and you guys are gonna see it really soon.
Here we are at Sudbury's Great Big Nickel, iconic for its grandeur, and because in Sudbury you can mine for nickel, I believe.
Can you actually?
I think so. We've been tracking through the fog for about 5.5 hours now. I think we left at like 5, it's 11:02. We had one stop, we had an almost near-death experience, it was pretty fun. We had a fun gas station experience where we were hearing things due to exhaustion and just the weirdness of the town. Lots of fog, and some delicious roast chicken flavored Lay's chips, which I highly recommend, Bryn highly recommends, and it's just an overall good time here on the road. So far, nothing but good vibes.
It was at this point, about 5 hours into the trip, when I decided I could use a little bit of a break from driving, plus I could get some cool videos of us on the road. Allie told me that she knew how to drive stick, but it had been a while, so I thought, why not, let's pull onto a residential street and I'll just remind her how to drive.
Gas in, clutch in.
Gas in? Jesus.
Where are you after this? Brake in.
Stop the car. I'll just drive.
Obviously, it did not go well. When we
got to Pancake Bay, it was pouring rain, but this provincial park is known for its beaches, so we just decided to take a dip.
Yeah. And nothing hurts anymore. I feel kind of free. We're still the kids we used to be. If I still bleed,
yeah.
And nothing hurts anymore, I feel kind of free. We're still the kids we used to be.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. We got some veggie chili going on over here. We got some Southwest chicken chili going on over here. It's wet as f-
the whole vibe.
But we do really be out here. So. Hot! I'm sorry you had to see that. Yeah. Hi. I want to get as much footage as possible. That first night at Pancake Bay really tested our alleged four-season waterproof tent from Mac. But when we woke up the next day, first thing in the morning, it was time to leave Pancake Bay and head on to the next campsite. And now, off to Sleeping Giant.
Difficulties.
It is a foggy motherfucking day. Coffee at the store that's nearby, but they only open at 9 a.m. now, and the gas was closed too, and the next gas station is 190 kilometers away. So I think that we'll make it, but anyways, here's Lake Superior. We're feeling good. White River, is that where we are? It's a little one street town, and apparently Winnie the Pooh was bought here by a soldier, but then he lived in the zoo.
Assume that mountain, this area over there, is where we're gonna be camping for the night. Sleeping Giant. So hopefully we're gonna go grab some foods, then we're gonna pick up some groceries, and then off to the campsite we go.
It's only 100 kilometer winds. Oh. 6:38, Sleeping Giant. Provincial Park. Severe thunderstorm warning with 100 kilometer per hour winds for the Thunder Bay and surrounding regions. That's where we are. How do you feel?
Day two and off to a great start. Love camping, love being wet.
They're the having damp a light. Fire.
Yeah, they are. And there's it's functioning.
Maybe we can try.
Join them?
Oh. No.
Living the damp life. We're already off to a crusty.
Sticky.
Crusty.
We are planning tomorrow's hike because tomorrow is going to be a good day.
Sunny.
No, we don't want short hike. I want to do the whole giant. It's top of giant trail. 6.6 kilometer round trip. Difficult. Tonight our plans are...
The rain's going to stop and...
Survive.
We're going to remain optimistic like we did yesterday, and if that...
Spoke too soon.
If that optimism doesn't get us anywhere, then it's okay. At least we tried.
We have no service. Our parents may think we're dead.
Nobody knows our location at the moment. Nobody knows we made it to the location that we are supposed to be at.
Holy shit. After being at Sleeping Giant for a couple hours, we decided it would probably be a good idea to call our parents and let them know that the 100 kilometer an hour winds had not reached us yet, and that for now we were alive. So we tried to figure out how to use the payphone.
I'm gonna make sure it's open. 1 second.
Is it not dialing?
1-6-1.
Oh, it's dialing now.
$11?
Hi, I'm calling you for $11 for 2 minutes from a payphone in the national park because we have no service. So I'm just letting you know that we're alive. We're alive and we won't have service until like for 2 days. Yeah, so we found a payphone. Yeah, and we set up a tent and it's not raining that bad and there's no wind. Knock on wood. Miss you too. Bye, love you. Okay, so what it's like, you're gonna dial the number?
Yeah. And then...
Does he want messages?
Oh, this really looks like the intro to a homemade porno right now.
Hot and heavy and steamy.
It literally is steamy. And the lightning is...
This is Wiggles. He's my best friend.
I only ever look at myself when I'm doing one of these updates and I look... very wilderness right now.
You look very crushed.
On Sunday night.
8:25. It feels way earlier because we didn't do anything today. Except for drive because it's really rainy.
It was sunny all day though.
It was sunny. No, it was foggy.
We hit fog and then we hit the sun patch and we're like, oh yay, it's gonna be nice out. And then...
It's so gross out, we did not.
And then we checked the warning.
Our teeth.
But we did set up the tent in less than 20 minutes.
And we're going to start timing it, I think. Mm-hmm. We'll see what time we can beat. It's a great day. We're camping.
As they listen to the rain pour.
Any day outside is a good day.
Any adventure is a good adventure.
It's a galve.
Hello everybody, we're here at the trailhead for Cabian Trail, which is an overnight trail, but apparently we have to hike half of the Cabian Trail to get to top of the Giant.
Which is the one
the
that
park ranger kind of laughed at us, told us it's going to take 7 to 8 hours. And from his face, he doesn't think that we can do it.
But we're here to prove him wrong.
Accept it. To our hike. We've come to this great lookout. We're still alive so far. Hike seems pretty chill. Everyone else on the trail has like hiking sticks and like overnight bags.
And here we are with our one pack and everybody laughs at us as they walk by.
But don't underestimate us. We're gonna make it to the top.
Oh,
looking immensely sweaty, but we've just hiked around 10.5 kilometers up. Oh, there's a sign over there that says if we made it to the top or not. We don't know if we're at the end of the trail or not.
Sandwich. Sandwich. Nuts.
Make sure I look not as bloated. Hello, everybody. We are at the top of Sleeping Giant. We are very sweaty. We just did the top of the Giant Trail. There are people coming, which is like, well, like 22 kilometer loop. So we're halfway, stopped for lunch, proving the park ranger wrong yet again. And yeah, it's a good day so far.
We did it.
We survived.
Oh man, that sweat. And it only took us how many hours?
4 hours and 40 minutes.
5 hours instead of 8. So to the park ranger who thought that we couldn't do it, my Apple Watch says we did 276 minutes of exercise.
Let me check my hand.
And burnt 1,721 calories. I don't know how much footage you guys saw of the uphill.
Exercise 543%.
Yeah, but the uphill was intense. I couldn't film it because we needed all four
limbs
to climb it. But I think now we're gonna get some water, maybe hit up the lake to cool off. Okay, stop right there. Before we continue, Allie and I didn't really realize how far north we were until it was literally like 9 p.m. at night. We were in our tent and it was still completely light out outside of our campsite.
I spent my time watching the spaces that have grown between us. Whoa. And I cut my mind on second best, all the scars that come with the greenness. And I gave my eyes to the boredom, still the seabed wouldn't let me in. And I tried my best to embrace the darkness.
Six minutes and 20 seconds for the whole tent. No, I don't know how we're gonna beat that one. Oh my god, look at me. Yeah, I would say the train definitely played a role in our
ski.
Good morning from Thunder.
My
seatbelt
undid at the same time it fell over, so I was like, what the heck?
Morning from the Thunder Bay Tim Hortons. Today is our final driving day in Ontario. So we're munching, we have service again, and then we're driving to Kenora.
Population
1300. There is not a gas station for another long time, according to the signs. So we're stopping. My windshield is a big crack.
I'll show it.
Okay, wait. That's Allie's gonna show you.
The sound she made was aggressive.
It like, made us our ears pop. So now I can hear it. We don't know when the next civilization is
going to
be.
There's not much civilization here. This is our civilization. This is what we're looking at. You are here.
What's up, guys? We're here in Dryden, Ontario. It's the first town we've seen in a while, population of 8,000. We're here at Max the Moose. He's pretty majestic. And we're gonna head off for some lunch somewhere. Earlier on, we crossed the central time zone area. We did not know that was happening today, so now we're an hour behind, and we were notified that all water in this area runs. How do you feel?
Excited. It's gonna hurt.
Form the crew about what's about to go down.
Cheers. We are both lactose intolerant. And these are blizzards.
With cheesecake.
You can have it if you don't mind. Some around the other stay with me. And you can fuse you with your riddles and your sudden generosity. Call me in the afternoon, even by one, by one. Call me in the afternoon, even by one, by one.
Can you see
that? No, you can't. I look like a maniac. It's so hot. Our time for today's tent setup, 10 minutes 46 seconds. To be fair, it is on rock. So the hammer time, I think,
took a little bit of time off.
Added some extra.
I think usually we would set up in like 6 or 7. Like from what it feels like, we usually set up in 6 or 7 because the ground's easier to like press into.
So I guess we'll see next time.
We'll see.
An illegal shower in the lake with biodegradable soap. So it's not that bad, even though you're still not allowed, but we feel good. My hair feels so nice. We used scent away from the hunting section in Cabela's so that the bears don't eat us.
Call me in the afternoon, even by.
Okay, so, oh, it's bright. The lighting in the nature, our record for putting away the tent is 6 minutes and 20 seconds. We're gonna try to beat it. With spiders.
Everywhere.
Good job, high five.
Like, they're everywhere. They're freaking huge, too. I don't think so.
I don't think so. Brynn!
Master of disaster, the best at fearing the worst. If we all die tomorrow, then I'm taking my time. I've got a river to deliver, then I'm having some wine. If we all die tomorrow, then it's been a blast. And if you're feeling kind of blue, love, then at least it won't last. If we all sad in a way, but hey, you've got a parking ticket that you don't have to pay. Oh. tomorrow.